we might have a federal election and start in the next week or two. So I want you to sort of do a thought process here and think about how you think the economic issues are going to be framed by the political parties in this election period. Gary Marr, I'd love for you to start this.
Well, I think that what the Liberals will do is they'll try and frame this by saying, you know, we provided a great deal of income support. We allowed the economy to continue to operate. We want to continue to do that and spend our way out of this problem to some degree. There's been a lot of spending. I think that the parliamentary budget officer has indicated that not all of it has gone into the places where it ought to. But if I were to say, I'm not opposed to the spending as long as area. So you've got, for example, a lot of money set up in the infrastructure bank that has not been spent yet. And yet, if you look at the importance of having trade infrastructure funded, that would be really good. And I think that the focus ought to be on shovel-worthy projects as opposed to shovel-ready projects. And, you know, I wouldn't propose that, you know, that a spending $600,000 on a skate park in Gabriel Island qualifies as a shovel-worthy event.
Right.
But there are projects that you could put forward that are ready to go that would help our ports, our airports, our roads, our bridges, that would help get what it is that we make and produce here in this country to marketplaces. Because in terms of our rankings internationally, Canada's rankings of infrastructure have steadily gone down in terms of their reliability, according to the surveys that are done of our major trading partners.
We've got about 30 seconds before the next break. I'm going to stick with you, Gary, very quickly. If you were the leader of the opposition, how would you frame that, the economic issues in that sense?
Well, I guess if I were the leader of the opposition, I'd be framing it in terms of these things that we're doing to support people's income, to support the healthcare system, daycare, for example. All of those things cost money, and they can be worthy, but you need to find a way to pay for it. And this is the part that I think has been lacking on the part of the government, is to figure out how you pay for all of this. And so if I were the leader of the opposition, I'd be focused on a plan as to how you create the economic opportunities to create the revenue that is necessary to support spending.